What's up, guys? My name's Brandon, and this past week was another interesting one as we got the release of iOS 14.7.1 on Monday, and then on Tuesday we saw the release of iOS and iPadOS Beta 4, along with the latest beta versions of watchOS, tvOS, and macOS. But in this video, we're going to discuss how iOS 15 Beta 4 has been running in terms of performance, connectivity, battery life, and also cover some additional new features and changes found in the software. And we're also going to be discussing iOS 14.7.1 and the features and security patches brought in that update. We're going to talk about when to expect iOS 15 Beta 5, potential iOS 14.8, and more. All right, so let's go ahead and kick things off with some additional new features and changes found in iOS 15 Beta 4, which is now out for developers and public beta testers. Of course, if you missed my initial video, that will be linked up in the cards and down in the description below. But we're going to talk about some additional new features and changes that I did not cover in my initial What's New video. And the first new thing I found is actually, it just happened tonight. I just found this right before recording this. If I go into one of my focus modes right here, so I'll just go ahead and do sleep because that's where I discovered this. If you go to the lock screen, you can see that we can actually tap on the focus from the lock screen now. So if we tap on this, it now opens up the focus right there. Whereas on previous versions, if we tap on it, it does nothing. So this is beta 3 on the left-hand side. We have to haptic press to open up that menu on previous betas. We also have a slight change inside of the Photos application here in beta 4. So if we swipe up on an animal or a plant, you can see that for whatever reason right now, the visual lookup is not working for me. So you can see here on beta 3, it is working. It identifies this as an animal. When we tap on that, you can see it will show that this is a cat. So it's working there, but for whatever reason, it's not working here for me on beta 4. But beta 4 kind of changes up the icon a little bit, and it moves the icon around on the image more. So also, I did notice that when we go to adjust right here, so we go ahead and tap on adjust to adjust the time and date of the photo, you can see that it now shows the original and the adjusted time right there. And you can see over here on beta 3, it only showed the original time right there. And then also up top, you can see that when you go to change it, it shows adjust. And before, it just said done up in the top right when you finish adjusting that photo's date and time. So just some minor changes here inside of Photos. And actually one more thing inside of Photos, if we go down to the For You tab and then go down to our memories right here, and we go to one of our memories, you can see that we can now share it. So before in beta 3 up in the top right, you can see that the share icon is grayed out. But now here in beta 4, you can actually share these memories. If I go ahead and tap on share, you can see it says choose shareable soundtrack. So you get to choose a soundtrack right here. So you can see we have all these different songs to choose from. So you can see we have dreamy, sentimental, gentle, you have all these different ones. So I'll just go and choose chill right here. You can hear it. Go and tap on done, and then you can share that memory right there, which Apple does a great job with these memories, the way they put them together. It's a lot better than it was in iOS 14. So I will definitely be sharing some of these, and I'm glad that we are now able to. And of course, you can just save the video there as well here in beta 4. Inside of the control center, we have a few changes here in beta 4. So first off, you can see the notes icon. That's what it looked like in the control center on beta 3. But now in beta 4, you can see it over here on the far right. That is the new notes icon. So when we tap on that, you can see the new icon displays right there as well when you haptic press on it. And also, if you look closely at the scan document glyph, it's slightly changed. So you can see there's like a piece of paper folded over, whereas before it was like a piece of paper with a few lines on it. So just a minor change there in the glyph as well. And then also inside of the hearing control center toggles, you can see the little ear right there. If we haptic press on that, you can see that background sounds used to have this icon down here in beta 3, but now in beta 4, it actually has a more, you know, accurate description or depiction, I should say, of background sounds with that new updated glyph, which I like a lot better. And then lastly, we have a slight change inside of the text size control center toggle right here. So if we go into that and we switch over from home screen only to all apps, you can see we have a little animation there in beta 4. So beta 4 on the right, beta 3 on the left. Here's what it looked like before. It would just go back and forth, but now we have a smooth little animation there inside of the control center toggle. And also the text is slightly bigger down below as well, whereas before it would be a lot smaller. Also, if we go back to the lock screen and we look at the little camera glyph down at the bottom, you can see that it has now been updated here in beta 4 to match the rest of iOS. So before on beta 3, you can see you have to look really closely, but the camera glyph has the little shutter button right there on the left-hand side. You can see it right there, but now here in beta 4, you can see it's been changed and it's a lot cleaner and it looks like it does on the actual app icon here in iOS 15. So it matches now on the lock screen. We also have a couple of small changes inside of the weather application. So first thing, you can see when it shows the time, look right here how it says 2 a.m. You can see the a.m. is a different font. It's kind of closer and smaller than the 2, whereas before in beta 3, you could see it just showed 2 a.m. in normal text. So Apple has done something a little bit different with how they put the AM and the PM after the time right there. Then also if we go down, you can see 10-day forecast is now smaller than it was before. So here on beta 3 on the left, you can see the font is a little bit bigger and more pronounced there. So it's a little bit smaller, which I like it smaller, I think. If we go down, we also have a few other changes down here. So if you look at the text all around, you can see that the text is a little bit less opaque than it was in beta 3, just all around. So where it says rainfall, humidity, feels like, all of that is more opaque and a little bit lighter than it was in previous betas. Also, the humidity glyph icon has been updated. So it's smaller and a slightly different look than it was in beta 3. And then also when we swipe down, you can see that the 86 degrees and partly cloudy is more opaque here in beta 4, whereas in beta 3, it was less opaque. So Apple's really messing with the opacity inside of the weather application on the text. Now, if we go into our settings and go to accessibility and then into voiceover, you can see that we have a new toggle here for quick settings. So you can see quick settings right here, right below typing. That was non-existent in beta 3. And if we go ahead into quick settings right here, you can see you have all of these different quick settings, which you can move around if you use voiceover, which is a nice new feature to have there. Now, if we go into our settings and go to privacy and then into location services, and then all the way down to the bottom to system services, and then all the way to the bottom and to significant locations, we have a slight change right here. So you can see that now shows a summary and recent records, whereas before it would just show your places and your history. So a slight change there. Also, you can see these are boxed off instead of taking up the entire screen. So a nice little change here in beta 4 to the significant location section inside of your privacy settings. Also, if we go into our settings and go to erase all content and settings, you can see there is some slightly different verbiage here in beta 4. So first of all, you can see there is more, you know, of a description for what you're about to do, whereas before it was just one sentence right there. And then also it said securely erase, but now it just shows continue or not now. Now also inside of a stacked widget, I showed you guys that we had a new little glyph icon here. If we go into edit stack, you can see that we have a new smart rotate and widget suggestions. Those are both new glyphs right there. But what I didn't show in my what's new video is that there's actually a really cool animation for the smart rotate right there. So if we go to edit stack and go to smart rotate, take a look at that animation. So that is a cool new animation here in beta 4 that was not there previously. So I really like that animation. Also, widget suggestions has a neat little animation there as well. I wish Apple would do these really cool animations all throughout iOS and not just kind of hidden inside of a widget stack right there. But that's also new in beta 4. So those are quite a few more new features and changes found here in beta 4. There are a lot that I found, a lot of really small things, but they are changes nonetheless. Now, one thing I want to cover that I talked about in my previous video, but a lot of people seem to be confused by this, and I'm not too sure why. I mentioned how there's a refresh button now on Safari, so inside of Safari, and a lot of people took it as though I didn't know that you couldn't swipe down to refresh. So yes, I covered that in multiple videos. I know that you can swipe down to refresh, but what happens when I'm all the way down here, you know, all the way down the page and I want to refresh? You know, if I want to refresh, it's going to take me right back to that page, you know, right back to that section I was on that page, like if I'm reading an article or something. I'm not going to always want to go all the way up to the very top just to refresh. So that was the whole point. You know, iOS, or Apple, I should say, introduced this new little refresh button there in beta 4, and it's very handy when you're all the way down the screen and you want to just simply tap to refresh. That's what I was talking about. That's what's new here and at beta 4, and I really like that little change to the address bar. And then I did also want to mention that the spotlight search bug has been fixed here in beta 4. So this is driving me absolutely nuts. In beta 3, it just simply would not work. Sometimes I would have, you know, blank spotlight icons. Sometimes I would have to type out the entire application for it to show up. And then even sometimes then, it still wouldn't show up. So spotlight search, you know, all the bugs I had with it have been resolved here in beta 4, thankfully, because I rely on that heavily. And then also in beta 3, I talked to you guys about a really strange bug I had, and a lot of people also had this bug, where you just simply could not stack the same sized widget. So if I go into here and I add this widget in right here, you can see that I can now easily stack the widgets as expected. So for whatever reason, in beta 3, you were not able to stack the same sized widget, which made no sense, but that has been fixed, of course. So there are quite a few changes and bug fixes here in beta 4, but unfortunately we still do have some bugs that need to be resolved. And the first one has to do with the now playing. So this is a bug I mentioned in my previous video, but sometimes when I'm playing music or playing a video, whatever I'm playing, if I'm playing any type of media on my phone, sometimes it just simply does not show up in my control center, on my lock screen. When I connect to like my Tesla, it doesn't show the song that's playing on the Tesla, or if you have like a head unit, it wouldn't show any information whatsoever. So this is still happening for some reason in beta 4. I'm hoping that it's fixed soon because it's very annoying. So of course it does get fixed with the reboot, but that's the only thing that fixes it is a reboot. Even when I close out of that application and go back in, it doesn't fix it, only a reboot does. Now also some users are reporting that live wallpapers are not working. So they're working fine for me. If you set a photo as a lock screen and then, you know, press and hold on it, it works and it shows up properly. But some people are having issues with live wallpapers just simply not working whatsoever. Now, some users, myself included, are also having issues with Twitter. So sometimes Twitter will just crash for no reason. Sometimes I'll be in the middle of typing a tweet or a reply to a tweet. Sometimes I'll just open it for the first time and it just simply crashes. So there do still seem to be issues with the Twitter application, even after it's been updated. So I'm not sure what's going on there, but that is the, you know, most talked about application that's crashing, aside from banking applications, which I also wanted to talk about. So a lot of people are still having issues with banks, you know, banking applications not opening at all. And then some users, like with Chase, are having issues with Face ID authentication. So I've had some users who have the Chase Bank application and they cannot log in via Face ID. So that's an issue. Some people said their banking apps work now in beta 4, whereas they didn't in beta 3. And now some people are saying that they don't work when they did work in beta 3. So it's just hit or miss at this point. Hopefully developers do update their applications to be compatible with these iOS 15 betas. Although of course, some of you guys will have to wait until iOS 15 is out to the general public. All right, so now let's talk about the performance and the connectivity. So first of all, the connectivity has actually been really good here in beta 4. So as far as cell connectivity, of course, I don't use my 12 Pro Max. I use my 12 Pro, which I am on the fourth beta right now, the fourth public beta, and connectivity has been fine. Really no issues with Wi-Fi or cell connectivity. And it seems like I've had a lot less complaints, at least so far, from connectivity on beta 4. So I'm hoping that that modem update and just overall connectivity is improved here. It is for me, and hopefully it is for you guys as well. Now, as far as the performance goes, performance is also excellent here in beta 4. It's definitely better than beta 3 in my experience. I knew that from pretty much first install. It just felt smoother, especially Safari. It still, to this day, you know, seems faster than beta 3. So I'm definitely, you know, having a great experience with Safari. Overall performance is great. The Geekbench scores are higher than they were in beta 3. Playing games is a breeze. Everything just feels really good here on beta 4. So if you were considering, you know, getting this on your main device and you don't have to worry about banking applications, or if you can like test it out, I would, you know, at this point say it's fine on a daily driver device. But if you want to wait until beta 5 just to be extra safe, I wouldn't blame you either. Now, as far as battery life goes, here is the one area where I would say that if you're, you know, kind of on the edge about updating your main device to iOS 15 beta, the battery life is still not great. You're still going to have worse battery life than on iOS 14.7 or 14.7.1. So, you know, I still get, you know, about 6.5 hours of on-screen usage on my 12 Pro, whereas I should be getting closer to 7 to 7 hours and 15 minutes like I did on iOS 14.5 or whatever it was when I went to the iOS 15 beta. So iOS 14, I was getting at least 30 minutes more of on-screen time. So battery life will take a hit, that's expected on a beta, but hopefully that does start improving with the next couple of betas. But I would say, again, if you're on edge, if you don't know if you should update your main phone to these iOS 15 betas, the battery life could be one thing that kind of holds you back. You may want to wait if you are really, really, you know, you really need the best battery life possible. I would just, you know, maybe wait until that does get improved a little bit. But that's pretty much it for iOS 15 beta 4. Really nothing but good things to say about it, honestly. I mean, I really don't have too many bugs outstanding that need to be fixed at this point. Performance and battery life seem great. We're getting a lot of new features and changes. Things are really looking up from here. So I did also want to talk about iOS 14.7.1. So I do have that on my iPhone 12 right here. So if we go ahead and unlock this, this is currently on iOS 14.7.1. So if we go into here, you can see we're on 14.7.1 here on the iPhone 12. Now this update was very minor. It really only fixed a bug with the Apple Watch unlock for Touch ID devices, and it did fix that. A lot of people are very happy that that has been addressed. Now, we did also have a major security bug that was patched in 14.7.1, and I did recommend in my video for everybody to update no matter what version you're on, because that exploit was being actively used. So 14.7.1, it was, you know, I did predict that that was going to come, and it sure enough, it did, and it's definitely one that you want to go ahead and install. Performance and battery life are just as good, if not better, than iOS 14.7. And of course, you are going to have a much more secure device here on 14.7.1. This, of course, is if you are not on the iOS 15 betas. But if you do want to downgrade, I did make a video on that, and you would downgrade now to 14.7.1, which is kind of just a better version of 14.7. All right, so now what is next for Apple? So if we go into the calendar right here, you can see that we're about to enter into August. Yes, 2021 is flying. I cannot believe it's already August 2021. So as for iOS 15 beta 5, we could possibly be on a 1 week beta cycle, but I'm starting to lean towards we're still on a 2 week cycle. I think that after beta 5 gets released, we will be on a 1 week cycle after that. Now, it is always possible to get a beta 5 next week on the week of the 2nd, but my guess is going to be that we're getting it on the week of the 9th. So I think that after we get beta 5 on the week of the 9th, then we'll switch over to a 1 week beta cycle, and we'll have beta 6 on the week of the 16th, beta 7 on the week of the 23rd, leading all the way in to September until the eventual final release of iOS 15 sometime in mid, potentially late September. Now, as far as an iOS 14.8 beta 1, I do still think that's possible. However, it would have to be released next week, maybe the following week, if at all. So I think that we could possibly see a 14.8 beta 1 next week or the following week. It's really hard to say at this point. You know, there's really, it seems like from, at least from the outside, that there's really no reason for a 14.8 to be released, but I still would not be surprised to see it. Of course, we could always see a 14.7.2 if Apple does fix another security bug. So we'll just have to wait and see, but those are my predictions for when we'll see iOS 15 beta 5, and of course, a potential for an iOS 14.8 beta to begin. So anyways, guys, there you have it. That is iOS 15 beta 4. Some additional new features and changes. We talked about the performance, the battery life, all that good stuff. There are actually a lot more changes in this fourth beta than I originally thought. So I found a lot of small things. Hope you guys enjoyed that. I really try to find, you know, the smallest details that have changed just because it's fun and it's actually something that's changed. So why not share it with you guys? But anyways, if you did enjoy this video and you appreciate all of the research that goes into these videos, I would appreciate if you gave this video a thumbs up. And of course, make sure you subscribe. I do have a lot more iOS 15 content coming very, very soon, especially in September, October, when it gets released to the public. I have a lot of banger videos ready for you guys. But anyways, thanks again for watching, guys, and I will see you soon.